Namaste, friends, and I hope you're doing well. Let's talk about Moon in the third house. Naturally, you have these very strong feelings towards your siblings. You're very possessive towards your siblings. You tend to get in touch with their personal problems. And this can lead into many issues because you, although they are siblings of yours and all that, but then you tend to cross the border because you're a very emotional person. Anything that you perceive in this world, an emotional effect will be on that thing. Okay, it doesn't matter. Even if you buy a car or whatever it is, there will be an emotional attachment towards that thing. So when it comes to siblings, you will naturally feel that you must help. Whether they ask for your help or not, you will naturally go to their doorstep and ask for their favor. Some of the siblings may not like this idea. Not only siblings, many people out there may not like the idea because they did not ask for your help. But you feel compelled to help. And that's the scene actually if you have Moon in the third house. This goes to the same to your friends, as well. And your friends will be slightly confused as who you are really, okay? Sometimes you want to be really helpful, sometimes, you know, you just ignore them, right? You know, that personality is always there in Moon, that split personality. Due to the waxing and waning state of the Moon, you naturally have your mood, mood changes. Although you're very soft in your speech and all that, but sometimes you can be pretty rude. Okay, so this confuses people in the third house. The people in the third house are your siblings, your close friends, and your neighbors. So these people will be naturally confused with who you really are. You know, this sort of identity problem will be also seen if you have Moon in the third house. Your self efforts will be also likewise. You know, if you have Moon very strong. Let's say if you have Moon with Jupiter. Which is the basis of the Gajakeshari yoga, which is a very powerful yoga. Gajakeshari is like it's like the world around you are in acceptance to your desire. Whatever you want, people around you will naturally understand and will be helping you to make your desire be fulfilled. That's the Gajakeshari yoga. It's a very, very, very auspicious, very you know, it's a great yoga to have actually. So what I'm saying is Moon, it has its greatness because Moon is very important. Sometimes it's even important than the Sun itself. So Moon, because for one reason, for simple reason, because Moon controls your mind, okay? That is why it's important to first analyze how Moon is situated in your charts. And how, you know, that alone will give you an assessment on how the other houses will turn out to be. Because if you don't have a strong mind, regardless of having any other good auspicious yogas or combinations in the other houses, it's not going to do much help because your mind is not strong. It's like you're going to get a lot of money, but then you don't know how to receive that. You know, it's just an example. Let's go back to Moon in the third house. Your self efforts will be, you know, you're either really hardworking or you're just outright lazy. You know, you're just sitting in the house and doing nothing, just watching TV all day. This sort of things will be pretty common for you. So the other thing about Moon in the third house is your self efforts must be always be, how can I say it? Must be complimented by someone. Someone has to come and say, hey, you're doing a great job. You know, someone needs to continually boost your morale. Because you know why? Again and again, Moon is emotionally connected to every aspect, right? So you naturally want people to come and tell you, hey, you're doing a great job, and you know, keep up the good work, and you will, you know, do better. You will move on better. You will go on even faster. And if no one comes and tell you, if there's no compliments, if you don't feel you're seen, you will naturally drop whatever you're doing. You know, this is pretty common if you have Moon in the third house. Now, your ambitions as well. You know, because moon, the third house represents your courage, your tenacity, how strong you are to achieve, you know, how brave you are to achieve your problems, to come over your adversities in life, right? So the third house is also known for that. You, if you have moon there, it can be a great ally, because moon is known for its mental power. It gives you a very strong mental power. All this can be analyzed with the Shatbala and many other concepts. But the moon gives you the mental power to move on, to get your courage, to get your ambitions, to get your motivations on the road. You know, it gets you what you really want, because the mind is very, very powerful. The thing about it is it gets confused, okay? It's very strong. It knows this is what will happen. Okay, it knows exactly the consequences of an action. So you, let's say your ambition is to be a doctor. Okay, you know exactly what to do. You know you always score high in your examinations. You do well with comparing with your other peers. You know, maybe you even write a medical journal. But then end of the day, you'll be confused as what exactly that you need to do. You'll be confused if even the medical rank is something that you wanted to do, or is it something else that you wanted to do? That sort of confusion, it comes in the last minute. It comes in at the right time when you need to make a good decision. This confusion comes in and spoils the whole thing. So this is something that you need to understand if you have moon in the third house. Your ambitions, your motivations, your self-efforts, your courage will be tempered at the moment that you need to use it, because that's what moon does. Moon, it confuses your mind unless it's in a very strong state, as I said, like the Gajakeshari, or it's you know, it exalts in Taurus. So if it has all these great dignities and statuses, then you can be rest assured your life will be beautifully paved, because moon is essentially how you think, how you perceive others. Okay. Now the third house is also about expressions. Needless to say, the moon is a very he has or she has the ability to convince a person by using their lingo. You know, they can use that, the correct methods of conveying a message. They are very tactful. They are very very confident as well. And they are saying, for one thing is, when they say someone is a counselor, and they have a moon in the third house, their job is to give counseling, right? Someone comes. Now the person who comes will immediately fall for it. Immediately thinks that, wow, this is the greatest counselor I've ever seen. He's doing a great job, or she's doing a great job. You know, she totally understands what my feelings are. He goes right to the root of my problem, because that's what they are. You know, these people who have moon in the third house, they can navigate through your heart to see where's your soft spot, and they can trigger certain things within you that you'll feel, wow, naturally this guy or this lady is very, very. This lady knows my problem intimately, because they want to get to you, or they want to know you more emotionally. They get very intimate sometimes as well, and this can be uncomfortable to many, right? Even to strangers, they can be like, okay, it's like they met, you know, they could have met this person for 5 minutes, and they say, oh, you know, no problem, I can give you a ride, you know, don't worry. You know, if your car is broken, okay, let me help you, or let me call someone, let's change tire, or whatever it is. They will really do it, and they'll do it sincerely. Of course, it comes with a price, okay? What else? The communicative skills is also very strong. But then again, it's not like Mercury. Mercury is a very logical thinking graha. Its communicative skills is very functional and practical. The moon's communicative skills is very emotional. Okay, it controls how the person relates, or rather the feel of studies there. That is why I'm saying, if it's on the if you have moon in the third house, the best thing you can be a marriage counselor, or counselor for people who are having distress in life, the rehabilitation counselors, these sort of fields would be very good for you. People who are into psychology, this sort of counseling, the counseling where it involves more emotional attention rather than logical and practical needs. So that's a little bit about what I think moon would do to you if it's in the third house. Until the next time, thank you. Namaste.